Welcome to the new lecture. We will be covering small glimpse of the last lecture. In the last lecture, we have covered several menus. For example, we have covered AutoCAD menu, that is a red color A icon on the top left corner. AutoCAD menu, which shows you new, save, save as, etc. After that, we have covered quick access menu. Quick access menu basically saves our click. After that, we have checked universal menu. After that, we have covered ribbons. After ribbon, we have covered tool palettes. And after tool palettes, we have covered view menu or view controls and show and hide several type of controls. And at the same time, we have resetted our interface. Today I have opened my AutoCAD interface. The same thing happened like the last day. When I open the AutoCAD interface, it is once again shuffled, means different type of toolbars are present here. To overcome this type of problem, I have to reset the interface at the starting. So I will go to AutoCAD menu. From there, I will go to Options. And in the profile tab, the bottom side, you will get a reset. Then I will click OK and everything will be resetted as our interface. And make note that we are working in 2D drafting and annotation workspace. For checking the workspace, we have to go bottom side of our screen. Here a one setting type of icon will be appearing. I will click on a small arrow, then I will click here drafting and annotation. Then drafting and annotation interface will be appearing. We have discussed that if we switch the workspace, your interface is a new type interface that is useful for creating 3D objects. So, for the beginner, it is required that we start with 2D drafting and annotation. After that, we have covered view controls. After that, we have covered view cube and navigation bars. And today is turn to cover the task pane. Task pane is basically bottom side icons, which I will be covering today in this lecture. We will not cover 100% icons present here, but I will discuss the icons which are useful during 2D sketching. And when we will switch to 3D during the learning process, then I will cover the required tools for 3D also. We will cover only 2D tools which are required in the taskbar. Basically, at the bottom side, it is the taskbar icons. I will be start covering one by one. So, our today's task is taskbar. Task pane is another name of same thing, that is called task pane also. We will be covering one by one task pane today. Sometimes you can observe that your task pane is very lengthy, and sometimes you observe that your task pane is very small, because some icons of the task pane, which is at the bottom side, are missing from the screen. सो वी हैव टू फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल कवर द कस्टमाइज बटन विच इज प्रेजेंट एट द एंड ऑफ द टास्क पैड. व्हेन आई होवर माउस एट द राइट बॉटम कॉर्नर साइड देन यू विल गेट ए थ्री लाइन आइकन दैट इज कॉल्ड कस्टमाइजेशन. कस्टमाइजेशन मीन्स यू कैन कस्टमाइज योर टास्क पैन आइकन्स एंड कंट्रोल्स एज पर योर नीड. यू कैन शो देम, यू कैन हाइड देम. सो व्हेन आई क्लिक ऑन दिस थ्री लाइन बटन देन ए विंडो विल बी अपियरिंग व्हिच शोज दैट व्हिच कंट्रोल इज ऑन द स्क्रीन एंड व्हिच कंट्रोल इज नॉट अवेलेबल ऑन द स्क्रीन. If you click on coordinates, then coordinates will be hidden from here. You can see here, coordinate is missing. Model space is also hidden. Grid, then grid is also hidden. Snap mode, it means you can click them to hide the icons. It means you can click every one of them and your task bar will be smaller and smaller. Once again, if you click them, then they will be appearing here. So, I recommend that first of all, turn all of them. And we'll start studying about from first to last one by one, that is at the number one place and that is at the bottom place. Every command has a specific function and you have to learn about them. I will start one by one from the start. That is the list. That is the list which is one by one we are going to cover, starting from the first one. First one is coordinate. Several time I will be clicking to view this list and I will go one by one, which is required in 2D. First button is coordinate. As all of you know, when we go to draw a graph or make some part, then to represent that we need a coordinate system. There are different type of coordinate systems available in AutoCAD also and in several drawing subjects also. For example, we have Cartesian coordinate system which represents space values as x, y and z. Similarly, we have radial coordinate system, or you can say this is called polar coordinate system also. This represent all the space values in the form of r, theta 1 and theta 2. Basically, it requires radius and two angles, and one more is cylindrical coordinate. I will be discussing all these three in a different video when I will be covering the coordinate systems of the AutoCAD. One is more, that is called cylindrical coordinate. I will cover all these three in a separate lecture. That is called, here you will get R, theta, and one is height of the cylinder, r, theta and radius. So here are three coordinate systems, but here in AutoCAD by default there is Cartesian coordinate system. It means everything will be represented as x, y and z, and sometime angle is required. Angle shows you in the 2D plane, there is angle also. but by default there is Cartesian coordinate system. If I say coordinate, then you will come to the bottom side and hover your backside. One, there is a one beauty of AutoCAD that when you hover your mouse on some icon, then it gives you name of that and a smart part description of that also. For the example, if I hover over this coordinate, then it will show its name. And if I stay there for some time, then it shows some help also. Here it is not showing in coordinate, but if I go to dimension, then if I stay for some time, then it shows you some more help also. If I go to line command, it will show you, once show you line, small display, then after some time it will open one more menu by which you can understand that what does the line. In the same way, if we go to the circle and stay for 2 or 3 seconds on the circle, then it will show you help, what is the circle, and you can see by the diagram that it is circle. When I go to the array command, a small tooltip will appear. After I stay there for some time, then it will show you what is your rectangular array. Scale, what is scale? That is the beauty of AutoCAD, that if you hover on the icon, once it shows a small help. If you understand the small help, it is okay. If you stay on the icon for some time, then a larger help window opens, which shows you some more details of the command. It means it is user friendly. You can hover on the command and you will get a small help. After some time you will get some larger help. In the similar way, if we come to the bottom, it shows you drawing coordinates. Drawing coordinates is basically your x, y, z value. If you see, I take some command, if I move our cursor, then it shows you x and y value. So here you can view, here there are 3 comma separated values. Comma separated values means x, y and z of the coordinate. So basically this is coordinate of your point where you are going to click the create the sketch. In the dynamic, if we see the dynamic, then here is a specify a point and your x, y coordinates are visible only because we are working in 2D plane, so only x, y is showing here. It means at the bottom side, the first one in the toolbar is called coordinate system and it shows you the x, y, z value of your point. So we have covered the first point. First, we have covered the first one, that is called coordinate, and that shows basically you x, y, z, for example 15.300, that is your x value, comma 16.200, that is your second value, and 20.200, that is your third point. That is a coordinate of your point that is shown using this coordinate button. As I have earlier discussed, you can show and hide from the here. So I will be hiding them for your convenience, that we have covered this, we can understand it easily. We have understood the coordinates. I will hide the coordinates. You can see here the coordinate is hidden now. After that, the second one is called model. If I check the list here, the second one is model space. So वी विल बी कवरिंग सेकेंड पॉइंट दैट इज मॉडल. बेसिकली दैट शोज यू इन विच मोड यू आर वर्किंग. हियर इज मॉडल. नाउ इफ आई स्विच टू पेपर स्पेस देन दैट इज कॉल्ड लेआउट. If I click on layout, the model become paper. It means that tab shows you are working in modeling space or you are working in model space. If I click on model, then you will get model once again. If I click on layout, then you will get paper. It means your model button has two modes. Your model button has two modes. One is model. When you are creating something in 3D space. And second one is paper. Paper means you are in layout space and you are creating some printing work. So this shows you model or paper. It means you have two options. If you are in modeling space, then it shows model. If you are in layout space, it shows you paper. So these two we have covered. So I will hide now model space also, because you know now what is model space. It shows you in which mode you are working. You are modeling or you are creating a print.